So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, as usually I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exam. Okay, chahe aap central government ka exam de rahe ho, state government ka de rahe ho, regulatory body, banking exam, CGL, any exam, PIB Current Affairs are the most important part of your exam. Okay, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to River Cities Alliance and you have to identify the correct statements. Okay? River Cities Alliance बनाया गया है by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, उसके regarding you have to identify the correct statement. So let's talk about the news first. So remember, Union Minister of Jal Shakti, Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, has launched this River Cities Alliance in partnership with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. This has been launched in partnership. There is a partnership between Ministry of Jal Shakti and Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. For this River Cities Alliance, from the Ministry of Jal Shakti side, it's National Mission for Clean Ganga, which has participated in launching this River Cities Alliance, and from the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs side, it is National Institute for Urban Affairs, which is located in New Delhi. Okay, now what is this River Cities Alliance? What is the objective of forming this River Cities Alliance? So it basically, guys, the objective is to discuss and exchange information for sustainable management of urban rivers. Jo urban areas mein rivers hain, uske sustainable management ke liye this alliance, the members of this alliance will exchange the information, will discuss the ideas regarding the sustainable management of urban rivers. Okay. Now there will be total 30 cities in this alliance. Total number of cities are 30, jahan pe major rivers flow karti hain hamare desh mein. The secretariat of the alliance will be set up at National Institute for Urban Affairs, which is located in New Delhi. And of course, the alliance will focus on three broad categories, three broad themes. Okay, and what are the themes? Networking, capacity building and technical support. Networking, capacity building and technical support are the three broad themes on which this alliance will, जो उनका काम होगा अलायंस का, वो इन तीन थीम्स के अराउंड फोकस्ड होगा. द वर्क ऑफ दिस रिवर सिटीज अलायंस विल बी फोकस्ड अराउंड दीज थ्री थीम्स विच आर नेटवर्किंग, कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग एंड टेक्निकल सपोर्ट. सो दैट्स इट फॉर दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. इट इज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ पार्टनरशिप बिटवीन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. यस, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर हरदीप सिंह पुरी. And he is also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. The Secretariat of the Alliance will be set up at National Institute for Urban Affairs, New Delhi. This is also correct. And it will focus on three broad themes, that is networking, capacity building and technical support. So all the statements are absolutely correct, guys, which means option E will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number two. Question number two says, consider the following statements with respect to PLI scheme for pharmaceutical sector and you have to identify the correct statement once again. Now the question is, why we are discussing about PLI scheme for pharmaceutical sector? Kyunki ye to pehle hi launch ho chuki thi, isse pehle hi. So there must be some news regarding this. That's why I have brought this question in front of you. So the news is that Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, which is the implementing ministry for this particular scheme, and who is the Minister of Chemical and Fertilizers? Mansukh Mandavia, the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, is also the Minister of Chemical and Fertilizers. So the news is that the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers has selected 55 applicants as beneficiaries under PLI scheme for pharmaceutical sector. So a lot of applications were submitted regarding the regarding this scheme. इस स्कीम में जो बहुत सारी एप्लीकेशन गई थी, एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल दोज एप्लीकेशंस टोटल 55 इंडस्ट्रियल कंपनीज हैव बीन सिलेक्टेड, एंड दीज 55 कंपनीज विल बी द बेनिफिशियरीज ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम, जिसका नाम है पीएलआई स्कीम फॉर फार्मास्यूटिकल सेक्टर. नाउ लेट्स टॉक इन ब्रीफ अबाउट दिस स्कीम. सो रिमेंबर, द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू एनहांस इंडियाज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कैपेबिलिटीज. ऑफकोर्स जितनी भी पीएलआई स्कीम है उन सब में जो बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव है, that is to enhance the manufacturing capabilities of that particular sector, jiske liye bhi wo PLI scheme launch hui hai. Okay, so here The objective is to enhance India's manufacturing capabilities in the pharmaceutical sector by increasing investment and production. Now, the benefit under this scheme, the what kind of support government will provide? So, financial incentives will be provided on the incremental sales. Financial incentives will be provided on the incremental scale on pharmaceutical goods and also on in vitro diagnostic medical devices. And do remember, the financial incentive will be provided for a maximum period of 6 years. Kitne time ke liye? 6 saal ke liye. Maximum period of 6 years ke liye, this financial incentive will be provided under this particular scheme. All right. Now remember, total quantum of incentives, जो टोटल पैसा है इंसेंटिव के फॉर्म में जो दिया जाएगा, दैट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली ₹15,000 crores, जो कि ऑफ कोर्स ऊपर नीचे होगा. एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट टू बी नोटेड हियर, दैट द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट एजेंसी फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम इज सिडबी, ठीक है. एंड द सिलेक्टेड एप्लीकेंट्स, द टोटल 55 सिलेक्टेड एप्लीकेंट्स आर ग्रुप्ड इनटू 3 कैटेगरीज, ग्रुप ए, बी एंड सी. इन ग्रुप ए देर आर 11 एप्लीकेंट्स, इन ग्रुप बी देर आर 9 एंड ग्रुप सी देर आर 35 एप्लीकेंट्स. And no need to go into the details of this group A, B and C categorization. वो हमारे exam point of view से important नहीं है, okay? So this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. Here you have to identify the correct statement. Total amount of incentives that will be given under the scheme is ₹15,000 crore. Absolutely correct. इतना ही दिया जाएगा. Total 155 applicants have been selected as beneficiaries. Is that so? No. 155 नहीं है. कितने हैं? Total 55 है. There are 55 beneficiaries selected. And the project management agency for the scheme is SIDBI. This is absolutely correct. So 1 and 3 are correct. Option C. Option C, guys, will be the correct answer. Only 1 and 3. So I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 3. Which says, consider the following statements with respect to industrial corridor program and you have to identify the incorrect statement. So this, guys, is a very important program. The government of India, through Ministry of Commerce and Industry, is constructing these industrial corridors across the countries, and till now total 11 industrial corridors have been approved, and these industrial corridors will be constructed in 4 phases, okay? And there are total 32 projects sanctioned till now. So abhi hum iski isliye baat kar rahe hain industrial corridor program ki, because dekho news mein hai to baat karni iski zaruri hai. Dharwad industrial area in Karnataka will be developed under Bangalore मुंबई इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर प्रोजेक्ट. जो धारवाड़ का एरिया है उसको डेवलप किया जा रहा है. बेसिकली दे विल बी धारवाड़ नोड विल बी डेवलप्ड अंडर द बेंगलुरु मुंबई इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर प्रोजेक्ट. एंड ऑफ कोर्स दिस बेंगलुरु मुंबई इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर प्रोजेक्ट इज द पार्ट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर प्रोग्राम. सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग अबाउट दिस न्यूज इज दिस प्रोग्राम. इस प्रोग्राम के बारे में आपको पता होना चाहिए. ये धारवाड़ वाले न्यूज ऑफकोर्स दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू आस्क इन योर एग्जाम. The important is industrial corridor program, ठीक है, इसके बारे में पता होना चाहिए. Now this Dharwad industrial area is being developed with the collaboration of National Industrial Corridor Development and Implementation Trust and Karnataka Industrial Area Development Board, ठीक है. Just remember this statement here. ये वाला बस point याद रखना है with respect to this news. बाकी industrial corridor program की थोड़ी सी बात कर लेते हैं. ये वाली चीज आपको याद रखनी है इसमें. So remember, industrial corridor program, under this program the Ministry of Commerce and Industry is establishing various industrial corridors across the country, and total 11 industrial corridors consisting of 32 projects have been approved under 4 phases. Now these industrial corridors, what is the objective of constructing these industrial corridors? So it will definitely boost the manufacture investment and it will provide a proper infrastructure to the industries, okay. And of course, the nodal ministry is Ministry of Commerce and Industry, and the implementing agency is National Industrial Corridor Development and Implementation Trust. Okay, so this was about this news. Is program ke baare mein yaad rakhna. This is very, very important. Now let's come back to the question. The program is being implemented by Ministry of Finance. Nahi, Ministry of Finance nahi hai, Commerce and Industry hai. 5 industrial corridors have been approved under the project. नहीं, 5 नहीं है. 5 वाली जो न्यूज है वो तो बहुत पुरानी हो गई. नाउ 11 इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर्स हैव बीन अप्रूव्ड एंड द प्रोजेक्ट विल बी कंप्लीटेड इन 3 फेजेस. नहीं, द प्रोजेक्ट विल बी कंप्लीटेड इन 4 फेजेस. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट हियर. ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which of the following institutes has developed antibacterial fabric launched by Union Minister of MSME, Mr. Narayan Rane? So this is an antibacterial fabric and it will be of great use in hospitals and other medical facilities. And it has been launched, do remember this, it has been launched by Union Minister of MSME, Narayan Rane, and it has been developed by Kumarappa National Handmade Paper Institute. Kumarappa National Handmade Paper Institute, which is located in Jaipur. And this institute works under the aegis of KVIC, Khadi Village and Industries Commission. Okay. So, इसमें आपको ये याद रखना है that antibacterial fabric कौन से institute ने launch किया है and which ministry has launched it. ठीक है, so it is Ministry of MSMEs headed by Mr. Narayan Rane. So it has been developed by Kumarappa National Handmade Paper Institute in Jaipur. Okay. Moving ahead to question number 5. Name the program which has been launched by Indo-German Science and Technology Center to promote women in the field of research and development. Very, very important question. बहुत ज़्यादा important है ये. Definitely exam में पूछा जाएगा. The name of the program, guys, is Visor. Name of the program is what? Visor, which stands for Women's Involvement in Science and Engineering Research. Women's Involvement in Science and Engineering Research is the name of the project, which in short is Visor, and it has been launched by Indo-German Science and Technology Center. Indo-German Science and Technology Center ne isko launch kiya hai. Remember, it is a joint collaboration of Department of Science and Technology from the Government of India and Federal Ministry of Education and Research from the Government of Germany. An objective, of course, is to promote women in the field of research and science and technology. So, wo to hume question mein clear tha. Remember, total 20 awardees will be selected per year. Total 20 awardees will be selected per year. And this Indo-German Science and Technology Center will support the awardees with the maximum amount rupees 39 lakh from the Indian side and 48,000 euro if the researcher is from the Germany side. Okay? So the name of the program is what? The question is regarding the name of the program only. It is Visor. ठीक है, ऑप्शन ए वाइजर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. हाउ मेनी ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सप्लाई स्कीम्स हैव बीन अप्रूव्ड इन उत्तराखंड बाय स्टेट लेवल स्कीम सैंक्शनिंग कमेटी. सो इस तरीके की एक स्कीम, ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सप्लाई स्कीम, वाज आल्सो लॉन्च्ड फॉर यूपी 735. अभी कुछ टाइम पहले हमने पढ़ा था 735 ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सप्लाई स्कीम्स ऑफ यूपी वाज लॉन्च्ड बाय स्टेट लेवल Scheme Sanctioning Committee under the Jal Jeevan Mission. And now the same drinking water supply schemes have been launched for Uttarakhand. And how many? 12. 12 drinking water supply schemes launch hui hain for Uttarakhand. Okay? So 12 water supply schemes of Uttarakhand have been approved by State Level Scheme Sanctioning Committee under Jal Jeevan Mission. Alright. Now remember, as of now, till date, out of total rural household, 48.79% rural household in Uttarakhand are getting water through tap. Okay? And the government of Uttarakhand has set a target to provide 2.64 lakh household tap water connection in this financial year, that is 2021-22. And by the end of 2022, all the rural households will get tap water connections in Uttarakhand. This is the target of government of Uttarakhand. And under Jal Jeevan Mission, in this financial year till now, 143.80 crores have been allocated by the center to the government of Uttarakhand under Jal Jeevan Mission. Right? And these 12 schemes will provide benefit to 293 villages spread over 7 districts of the state. Okay. So, guys, this was about this news, and therefore the correct answer will be what? 12. Option C, 12. Now moving ahead to question number 7. And now guys, iske baad jitne bhi question hai, these are very direct question. You do not have to go into the details of these news. Bas question padho, answer mark karo, and that's it. Usse upar nahi pucha jayega. Theek hai? To andar detail mein jane ki zarurat nahi hai. Name the digital customer feedback program launched by Indian Oil, BPCL and HPCL. Kaun sa customer feedback program inhone launch kiya hai? So it is Darpan at petrol pump. And it is nothing but a customer feedback program. A customer who is taking service from any of these three petrol pumps can provide feedback at the petrol pump. And they have also launched a model retail outlet scheme. Model retail outlet scheme. All these three Along with this feedback program, they have also launched Model Retail Outlet Scheme, under which all the retail outlets across the countries of these three companies will be evaluated on the basis of certain parameters, like what type of services they are providing to the people. Okay, so Model Retail Outlet Scheme, ye bhi yaad rakhna, it was also launched by Indian Oil, BPCL and HPCL. But here the correct answer is what? Darpan at petrol pump. Question number 8 pe chalte hain. Center has constituted a group of food secretaries from states to deliberate on the framework of the DASH scheme, fill the gap. So this scheme has not been launched yet, but it will definitely be launched in the future. And for that, a group of food secretaries has been formed by the center to formulate the framework of this particular scheme. And the name of the scheme, guys, is Community Kitchen. Option A, Community Kitchen Scheme, is the correct answer to this question. Question number 9 pe chalte hain. Which of the following organizations has organized a webinar on Make in India Playing Safe with Toys? Now, is question ko dekh ke, you must be wondering, the answer could be KVIC, the answer could be TriFed, NAFED. But here, very surprisingly, the answer is Bureau of Indian Standards. Bureau of Indian Standards is the correct answer to this question. This webinar, Make in India Playing Safe with Toys, has been organized by Bureau of Indian Standards. Option D is the correct answer. Question 10 pe chalte hain. Which of the following ministries has conducted Swachh Office Drive to promote a healthy and hygienic environment? Very direct question, and there is no need to go into the details of this campaign, this awareness program. So Swachh Office Drive was organized by Ministry of Electronics and IT, headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav, to promote a healthy and hygienic working environment across all the offices of Ministry of Electronics and IT. Okay? Question number 11. Which of the following banks, along with Federation of Indian Export Organization, has organized banking conclave for exports in Mumbai? ठीक है, ये एक banking conclave हुआ था for exports in Mumbai. It was organized by Federation of Indian Export Organizations in collaboration with Union Bank of India. Option B, Union Bank of India, is the correct answer. And the last question for today, question number 12. Where has Joint Regional Official Language Conference been organized by Department of Official Language of Union Home Ministry? Who is the Home Minister? Of course, we all know, Mr. Amit Shah. And this Joint Regional Official Language Conference was held at Kanpur. Option B, Kanpur, is the correct answer. And of course, Kanpur is in Uttar Pradesh. Okay. So that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I will soon come up with the session on best questions of the month of November. ठीक है, तो एक दो दिन में आ जाएगा. And definitely there will be a session on NFHS-5 and ASER report. Okay. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.